So I thought Deadpool was quite good, but had serious room for improvement. And some of you thought it was the best movie ever made, and then many others fell somewhere around those areas. But I think that what we can all agree on is that every single person walking out of Deadpool had the exact same reaction. I can't wait for the sequel! And I'm not just talking about moviegoers, but also the suits at 20th Century Fox, who have already greenlit said sequel. So today, as we all come together in anticipation of that sequel, I'm going to share my top 5 ideas for Deadpool 2. And I hope you'll share your own ideas for the sequel in the comments down below. Okay, let's get started. Number 1, mo' money, mo' action. Yes, Deadpool 2 seriously needs a bigger budget. But based on the impressive box office returns out of the gate, a bigger budget for Deadpool 2 is definitely in play. Now, here's why I want more action in the film. I thought that the action sequences, there was only really one big action sequence at the beginning, but I thought that's where Deadpool really stood out. That's where Deadpool made waves. And that's because not only was the action I thought it was very well realized. As I said in my review, it was like watching an artist at work, but also it was very inventive. The counting of the bullets, etc. It was, not something you'd seen before. So I wanted more of that. But I understand that they couldn't afford it for Deadpool 1. But Deadpool 2, they should be able to at least have 3 major action set pieces. One in the beginning, because it worked so nicely this time. One in the middle, but then the most spectacular action sequence at the end, as is the way it is supposed to go in said movies. And have everyone leave the theater just with their minds blown, just like everybody felt after the first 20 minutes of the movie. So that's the first reason I would like a bigger budget. Also, it would allow Wade Wilson to have a weapons upgrade. In the comics, he has a transporter, which I think is really cool. He wears it on his, I guess for lack of a better word, utility belt. And I think it would be great. It would give him also, more opportunity to create mayhem because he doesn't have to call a taxi to wherever he wants to go. That really grounds him in a low budget way. Now, the taxi joke was funny. Him having to call a cab to go to his mission, so to speak. But maybe the transporter could malfunction, as it has sometimes also in the comics. He could lose it. I think that you could therefore have both and it would be a lot of fun. And with the action set pieces, I want them to not only to continue to be very well rendered, very inventive, but also really wacky. I want an even wackier group of action set pieces for the sequel. And the reason I introduced the word wacky is because that's my number 2 idea for Deadpool 2, a wackier Deadpool. Because let's face it, Ryan Reynolds' Wade Wilson really wasn't so crazy as just super upset about what happened to him, and understandably so. I don't think anybody who was new to the character would watch that movie and feel Wade Wilson was mentally ill. But in the comics, he's supposed to be. Actually, a number of people asked me before they saw the movie, in that time period between when I'd seen it and they hadn't, oh, was Deadpool crazy? Did they show his psychotic, fractured psyche? And I was like, unfortunately, they did not. They hinted at it with Vanessa, with the animated figures that came in around her, and I thought that was very clever. And we'll get to that in just a moment. But first, I want to point out, why is he crazy? Well, for those of you who aren't familiar with the character, the same thing that makes his cancer cells go crazy, the healing factor, also does a number on his brain cells, which are constantly shifting as a result. And so that's why he's lost his mind, and he often doesn't remember who he is or his backstory. And I think it not only leads to a lot of funny things and elements for the character, but if you're talking about a true R-rated adult superhero, why not give him that tragic backstory and foundation that kind of grounds the humor, right? It would be great to see Deadpool go from dramatic, hilarious highs to devastating lows, like he does in the comic. Also, it would make him, I think, very sympathetic. Some of the more mainstream reviewers in the old school traditional press had very harsh words for this movie, way harsher than anything I had to say. And I think that maybe they said that they thought that Wade just seemed like a jerk and very literally unsympathetic. So if he had this element, I think that would help him, maybe be something that, and also would give a reason for his craziness that maybe was anchored it a little bit more for people not familiar with the character. Then, as I said, that animated stuff with the characters with Vanessa was hilarious. And it was really funny and, again, very inventive. And so I would like to see it go full SpongeBob. And the reason I bring up SpongeBob is if you've seen SpongeBob SquarePants, Sponge Out of Water, the sequel, There's the super trippy time travel sequence, which is done to Pharrell Williams' Squeeze Me, and it's the best thing in the movie. I actually put a link to it down below in the video description so you can watch a clip from that, and it's just fantastic. And if they could put stuff like that in Deadpool 2, I think it would take the character to even greater heights and make him even more unique and realize his full potential. Like, for instance, a Deadpool musical number, I think, yes, please. All right, so that's my number two. Number three, Deadpool is a ladies' man. You know, he has all this, self-doubt. He's a little bit like the Beast in Beauty and the Beast, right? And women love that. They love a fixer-upper, and Wade Wilson is the ultimate fixer-upper. Also, there's something, very sexy about someone feeling, oh, am I good enough for you? You know, like, I feel I want to be my best for you. And, you know, women often will be like, oh, come on out. You know, I think it's something you see all the time in literature, and I think that Deadpool has used that in the comics, and he should use that in the movies. So I want to see more female characters, basically. Now, for instance, Vanessa loved Morena Baccarin in this movie. Loved her so much and was so disappointed that she wasn't Copycat. Now, this isn't feminism speaking. This is just someone who's a fan, who loves a character, wants to see themselves in the movie, kicking butt, so to speak, an extension, right? And just like a lot of guys love Deadpool for being able to be Deadpool, I think a lot of women would love to see Copycat do her thing. And let's not forget that in the comics, when Deadpool first meets her, she's already a mutant. And so there was really no reason to depower her, I guess, besides the lack of budget. Although I wish in the first movie they had sowed the seeds for her becoming Copycat in the second, with her being injected with whatever turned Wade Wilson into a mutant, you know, being accidentally or intentionally injected into her by Ajax in the big climax of the film. So, also, Copycat has a wonderfully adult story about being this prostitute who, you know, refuses to turn on Wade Wilson and turn him in, even if it means her own death, and, a real loyalty. And so I think that would be great to explore in the sequel. So there's so many places to go with Vanessa, and I'd really like to see that happen. You could also bring in a love triangle. Now, I think Deadpool could have a lot of fun with a love triangle because, you know, he's so meta and he comments and all this stuff. And of course, there are people have a real love-hate relationship with love triangles in movies. So who else would be part of this love triangle besides Vanessa, aka Copycat? Well, you've got Siren, the Irish X-Men, the daughter of Banshee. She would be great. She has a wonderful history with Deadpool in the comics. Being the real sweet girl next door, that could be, I think, really fun. Kind of the Sandy to his Danny Zuko. A little Grease reference for you there. And then also there is this character called Shikla. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. She's recently been in the comics. She's a succubus, which is a female demon who seduces men and steals their souls. But she falls in love with Deadpool because she's, you know, a monster inside herself, even though she has nicer packaging. And they actually get married in the comics, so that could be really interesting as well. So I think that this would be something that would be fun to see these characters realized on screen, but also it would provide a lot of material for Deadpool himself. Then number four, which I'm sure is many people's number one, X-Force, and that includes Cable. And of course, Deadpool was first introduced in the pages of X-Force with Cable. Domino, Boom Boom, Richter, characters we haven't seen in the movies yet. So that could be a lot of fun. It could give Deadpool some unique X-Men to interact with. I'm torn on this because I don't really want to see Deadpool as part of a team. I would really like to see him more operate on his own. I think it works with the character. Also, Deadpool's so good in his action sequences, I don't want to dilute said action sequences by having to cut to other people on his team. I just want to see Deadpool be Deadpool. However, I said three action pieces, right? So I'm not opposed to one of those involving other characters, other mutants. I thought that because of budgetary reasons, yet again, Negasonic Teenage Warrior, Warhead, and Colossus were, somewhat, well-realized, but they really wouldn't go to town with their powers. And Boom Boom and Richter and Cannonball and Cable have cool things about them that could be done. So I wouldn't mind seeing them, and it would be a wonderful ode to Deadpool's origin, but I would like to see them there, but I don't want to see them there too much. I don't want it to become an X-Force movie. That's something that Ryan Reynolds would also like to make on the side. But if I were Fox, I would just double down on Deadpool, and I would if I was going to use X-Force, it would only be sparingly in Deadpool 2. Then my final idea for Deadpool 2 is make it more a spoof of superhero movies. I think that one of the best critiques of Deadpool, which actually I didn't have no problem with this when I was watching the movie. I had some pacing issues, but this didn't bother me. I guess because I'm so used to origin stories as a comic book fan. But a lot of non-comic book readers, old school traditional, critics, media, said that for something that's trying to be so subversive, it doesn't come across as subversive in the story. You know, it's the same old paint-by-the-numbers origin story. And I thought that was a very good critique. So I would like to see Deadpool 2 really, build on that, capitalize on that critique, and be more of a spoof of origin stories. Be more of a spoof of superhero characters. And the interesting thing about spoofs is that if something is a spoof, it doesn't have to worry about copyright infringement. You can do whatever you want if it's in the name of making a joke. That's how you can have movies like the Scary Movie films, etc., because it's all done in the name of, humor. So Deadpool could have versions of Spider-Man. You know, Deadpool and Spider-Man have a great history together in the comics. There's even supposed to be some kind of romantic flirtation going on there, or at least from Deadpool's perspective. You could have, they referenced Wolverine, so they can borrow anybody, of course, from the Marvel characters that Fox has the rights to, but they could totally spoof the Avengers and all kinds of different things, and I think really go super meta, super commentary on the superhero genre, and just really, turn it up, much further than they did in the first film. That's something I think would be a lot of fun, and I think that's something that the genre is ready for. Brad Bird can't be the only one delivering a commentary on today's superheroics. So again, those are my top five ideas for Deadpool 2. I'd be very curious to hear what you would like to see in the sequel, which it looks like we will almost definitely be getting. So thank you so much for tuning in. I look forward to discussing Deadpool with you, not just here, but I'm sure in many more videos to come. And you can check out some other episodes about Deadpool and other movies right now.